Welcome. In this video, we will see how to use the push button in MATLAB GUI. So to open the GUI, you have to type here guide in the command window. So now a new window opens. Here we have different options. Out of that, we have to select a blank GUI, that is the default option. Then click on OK. So it will open the GUI environment. So here you can drag and drop the different components that are available on the left side panel, and you can create your own GUI. So in this video, we will see how to use this push button. Okay, so this is a push button. So I will just click on that and drag and drop on this layout. Okay, so I can increase or decrease the size of this push button. Okay. Now, whenever we have a push button, in order to execute some command or some program, when I push this push button, to do that we can right click on this and click on the view callbacks and then click on callback. But now before doing this change, I will just open the property inspector of this push button. So to open that, you can double click on this. So all the properties related to push button will open, right? So here there are different properties that, like background color, you can change the color of that button, then you can enable it or disable it. You can have different options for this push button. Okay, so out of that, now we are going to use this string. Okay, so here the string indicates the name of that push button. So what I'm basically going to do is, when I click the push button, the color of the background window should change. Okay, that is the task that I'm going to do in this video. So for that, I will just change the name of that push button. So I will type it as change color. Then another important thing is the tag. So tag is the name by which the push button will be identified in the program. So we can give any name from which you can understand which button you are referring to. So I will again give here name as change color button. Okay, change color button, and click on enter. So I'm just going to modify these two properties and I will close this. Okay, now after that, again, if I click on this background, you will see here the tag of this background. So that tag is figure one. So this background will be referred by figure one tag name. Okay, so I can change that name by double clicking on that. I will get the tag option over here. Here you can see figure one is there. You can change this to any other tag name, but right now I will keep it as it is, that is figure one. Now I want to change the color of this background when I click the push button. So we have here the option of color, right? So R, G and B, that is red, green and blue. So combining these three colors, the background color is formed. Okay, and these three variables range in between 0 to 1. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, when I click on that push button, three random numbers will be generated between 0 and 1, and using these numbers, a specific color will be generated and that will be given to this background. So every time I click this change color button, the background color will change. Okay, that is the task that I'm going to do. So now I can right click on this and then click on view callbacks and go to callback. So now it will ask us to save this file with some name. Okay, so I will give some name like push button demo. Click on enter. So now it will open a .m file which is having the code related to the entire GUI. Okay, so for that, now again you can go to this figure window. Here again I can go to right click on that, go to callback. So it will come over here. So here I have to write the program to change that background color. So I have to combine the three R, G and B numbers into a single three-dimensional vector. Okay, so let's say the name given to the vector is col, col colon comma colon comma 1. That is the first plane which is having the red color. So I'm going to use the inbuilt function as rand, which will generate a random number between 0 and 1. Okay, so the second plane will be again colon comma 2. This will be again a green plane, and colon comma 3, that is equal to rand. So I have generated a variable called as col, which is going to have a specific color which will be generated randomly. Okay, now I want to set the color of the background. So for that, the command set, then handles dot the tag name of the background, that is figure 1, okay, comma, and the name of property that you are going to change, right? So I have to write that in single inverted quotes. So the property name is color. Okay, and here you have to give the variable which is going to have the three random values generated. Okay, that is col. So I will type here col. Okay, now after that I can save this file and I can simply run this file. Okay, so when I do that, this figure window will open, and when I click on this, you can see the background color has changed. So again, if I click on this, the color changes. If I click on this again, the color changes, right? So in this way, we can modify the color of the background just by clicking on this push button, right? So that is how we can use the push button for creating GUI. Thank you.